हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज गजानन पाठे फ्रॉम प्रभात किड्स स्कूल। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू वन अनादर लेक्चर ऑफ आवर ऑनलाइन प्रोग्राम। स्टूडेंट्स, इट्स राइटली सेड, इफ यू वांट योर चिल्ड्रन टू बी स्मार्ट, टेल देम स्टोरीज। इफ यू वांट देम टू बी ब्रिलियंट, टेल देम मोर एंड मोर स्टोरीज। Storytelling is one of the oldest form of teaching. It bonded the early human communities, giving children the answers of the biggest questions of life and afterlife. Stories define us, shape us, control us, and make us. Not every human culture in the world is literate, but every single culture tells stories. That's why we have come up with a new story from class 9 moments, and the name of the story is In the Kingdom of Fools. Basically, In the Kingdom of Fools is a folk tale taken from A.K. Ramanujan's Folk Tales from India. In the Kingdom of Fools is a folk tale that brings to light the dangers posed by foolish people. It also emphasizes the view that people, foolish people, can be very difficult to manage. They can be dealt with only by wise and calm people. So, In the Kingdom of Fools is based on the theme that foolish people are unpredictable and can be dangerous. So, one must stay away from them even if they offer some benefit for some time. The disciple got tempted by the availability of all the items for one dado each and stayed in the kingdom of fools in spite of the warnings of his wise guru. If the guru hadn't returned to rescue the disciple, he would have had to pay for his temptation through his life. Now let's talk about the poet. A.K. Ramanujan was an Indian poet and scholar of English literature who wrote in both English and Kannad. His works of scholarship include The Interior Landscape, Love Poems from a Classical Tamil Anthology. Ramanujan was a poet, scholar, professor, a philologist, folklorist, translator, and playwright. Now, let's begin the summary of the chapter. Now, as we discuss, it's all about the kingdom of fools. Now, background of the story, why the kingdom is called the kingdom of fools. In the kingdom of fools, the king and the minister were idiots. They ordered all the things to be reversed. Everything was reversed in the kingdom. They decided to change night into day and day into night. They ordered people to do the day's work in night and sleep in the day. Anyone not obeying was to be punished with death. So people, out of the fear, did as they were asked to do. This delighted the king and the minister. You can just understand how the kingdom was full. Initially, the king and the minister were idiots. The rules of the kingdom were totally reversed. They changed day into night and night into day, and people had to obey it because there was a fear among the people. If not obeyed, then they would be punished. The king and the minister were happy because they thought that the project was successful. Now, after a guru and a disciple, they visit the city. Once a guru and his disciple arrived in the city, they found everyone asleep during the day. No activity was observed. It amazed them. They wondered till evening when people woke up. They started doing their nightly business. Now the two were hungry. They brought some food items. The price of everything was same, a single daddu. This surprised and delighted them. The guru realized it was really a kingdom of fools. Now, what happens when the guru along with his disciple arrived the city, they found that everything was totally reversed. During the daytime, they didn't find anybody, and at evening time, everybody came out from the houses. They started their business. Now, when both were hungry, when they required some food, when they went to purchase food, they found that the price of every item was the same, one single ditto, and it surprised them. Now, the guru was a very sensible man. He realized that it was the kingdom of fools. Now, after this scenario, as the guru was sensible one, he understood that it was very dangerous to be there. So he decided to leave the city. But what about the disciple? The guru decided to leave the city of fools. He asked his disciple also to leave the place, but the disciple didn't want to do so for cheap food. The guru advised the disciple that nothing could be predicted of fools, but the disciple didn't care. He remained behind. Time passed on. The disciple ate to his fill. As a result, he became very fat. As guru was very sensible, he advised his disciple not to stay there. But the disciple was a greedy one. He decided to stay there. Guru, he decided to leave the city because he knew that the fools could be very dangerous and unpredictable. Now later, what exactly happens? One day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. Broke into means forcefully entered. He was taking out the stolen things. As he was taking the stolen things, exactly the same time, just then, the wall of the old house fell on his head. And in this accident, he was killed instantly. The brother of the thief complained to the king about the death. He blamed the owner of the house for his brother's death, because according to his brother, they were very honestly doing their business. And what was the business? Their business was of robbery. And according to him, the owner of the house was accused because the wall of the house was not strengthened. Now, what happened later? The owner is summoned. The king heard the accused. He accused him of killing the thief, the owner of the house, because his wall was weak. But the owner said that he was innocent. He said that the person who built the wall was responsible. But according to the owner, who was responsible for that killing, and obviously that was the bricklayer, because he didn't do his work properly. He didn't make the good wall. The king declared to summon the bricklayer. Summon means to call someone formally. And in this way, it was decided that the bricklayer should be summoned. Now, when the bricklayer was summoned, the king asked the bricklayer if he had built the wall. He accused him of killing the thief. Before the king could order his death, the bricklayer pleaded innocence. He told the king that he could not concentrate while building the wall. A dancing girl moved in the street, so he was responsible. So she was responsible for it. Now the bricklayer, he was also a very, a tricky person. He said that when the wall was being built, actually his concentration was disturbed by a dancing girl, because the dancing girl was going to and fro and it distracted him. That's why the dancing girl was responsible. Now again the dancing girl is summoned. The king charged the dancing girl of killing the thief. The dancing girl said that the goldsmith was responsible for it. Now she denied all the accusations. She said that she was not responsible. She had given some gold to the goldsmith. He had to make some jewelry for her. He was lazy. He did not make the jewelry early. So she had to walk up and down the street. So it was the goldsmith's fault. She denied all the allegations by saying that the goldsmith, he delayed the jewelry, and because he was lazy, because he let her to go and fro again and again, it was the goldsmith's fault. And again, the story that moved further. The goldsmith, he was summoned. What he said? The king now ordered to summon the goldsmith. The goldsmith replied that there was a wedding in the rich man's house. Now, why he delayed to prepare the jewelry? Because actually he wanted to do it at time, but there was a marriage at the rich man's house. He had to make jewelry for him, so he could not finish the jewelry of the dancing girl. The delay work of the dancing girl, it was because the man, the wealthy man, the rich man, he required some jewelry as early as possible. That's why it was the delaying of the girl's dancing girl's jewelry. So the rich man was summoned. The rich man summoned before the king. The king declared the rich man to be murderer. He was also the owner of the house. You know, there is a full circle of the crime scene. Again, the story rich, where it all started. The rich man was none other but the owner of the house whose wall fell on the robber. But he said that his father had ordered the jewelry. The king consulted his minister. He decided that the owner be punished in his father's place. He tried to convince the king, the owner, he tried to convince the king that the wall was erected by his father, and that time he wasn't there. But after consultation, as he inherited all the wealth from his father, he was responsible for the murder, and it was decided he would be executed. He decided that the owner be punished in his father's place. The king asked for a new stake to be made ready for the owner to die. Now, stake is a wooden piece that is used to execute people. So a stake was prepared to execute that man. But the owner was very thin. And what was the problem? The stake was a new one, and it was, the man was not suitable for the stake because he was very thin. He could not be executed. The king was worried about it, then ordered to search a man who was fit for the stake, he should be executed. And finally, after consultation, it was decided that there would be a man who should be found, and he would be executed, who would be very fat. So finally, it was all decided. So it was a searching of a fat man. Just remember, the guru and the disciple came, and the disciple, he remained, he became fat. And just what happened? Now the disciple was in trouble. The disciple was found fit for the stake because he was very healthy, because he was very fat. He was brought to the place of execution. It was decided he was suitable to be executed. He was brought there. The disciple now remembered his wise guru's words. Now repentance. He repented and he realized, he remembered the words of his guru. He prayed to his guru. The guru had magic powers to see the past and the future. The guru, he was with all wisdom and with all magic powers, who could see past and future. He saw that the disciple was in danger. He arrived at once to save the disciple. He told the disciple something in a low voice. The disciple understood this. As he reached there, he whispered some words in the disciple's ear, and the disciple understood what he had to do. Now, the guru came up with some tricks. What tricks he had? The guru and the disciple now started fighting. Now, what was the fighting? What was the reason of fighting? The guru wanted to die first, and the disciple wanted to die first. The king asked the guru why he wanted to die. It created confusion for the king. He didn't understand the reason why both of them wanted to die first. The guru told the king, in his ears that their city was unique. This was the stake of God of justice. The stake was new. It was never used earlier on criminals. Whoever died on it first would be born a king. Whoever died next would be born as a minister. As I told you, the guru was full of wisdom. He explained to the king that the person who would die first would become a king in the next birth, and the later person, the second person die later, would be a minister, because the stake was new and the stake was of God's justice. That's why there was a fight between the guru and the disciple to die first. Now the king was really confused. Why he was confused? The king thought over the whole case. Now he didn't want to lose the kingdom. He wanted to retain the kingdom. So he didn't want to lose the kingdom even in his next birth also. So he talked to his minister. The king said that they would go on stake themselves. Thus they would be reborn as king and minister. The king and the minister, both they decided to get executed. The king first and the minister second. The king and the minister went secretly to the prison where the guru and the disciple were kept. Secretly they reached there. They released the guru and the disciple. They put themselves in their places. So they were taken to the stake and executed. And in this way, the guru and the disciple, they escaped from it. And the king and the minister were executed. Now, the death bodies of the king and the minister were taken down as they disguised themselves as guru and disciple. The king disguised himself as guru and the minister disguised himself as disciple. Both were taken. The dead bodies were taken down. The people mourned their deaths. People were sad. They were unhappy. They started crying. They discussed the future of the kingdom. The big question before them, who would be the next king of the kingdom? Suddenly, some people thought of the guru and the disciple. They had an idea that guru and disciple worthy to be king and the minister. They were secretly leaving the city. People saw them. They requested them to be their new king and the minister. But they put one condition. Actually, the guru was not actually interested to be a king of the kingdom, because he knew that it was a kingdom of fools and he didn't want to be the king of fools. It was to change all the old laws, but yet there was a condition, and according to the condition, if all the laws changed to normalized situation, then they were ready to be king and minister. So they changed the law, and in this way the guru became the king and the disciple became the minister of the city, of the kingdom. Now it's a very humorous story, as we discussed how the king and the ministers were foolish, and how sensible and how with wisdom the guru and disciple were. Now we have a message from this story. What message we have? The first message is that one should stay away from foolish people. Foolish people are really unpredictable. So we should stay away from them, else one is bound to suffer. Otherwise, we have to suffer a lot. And the second important message from the story is that in order to tackle foolish people, one should employ wisdom and not the logic. You cannot employ logic. You have to live with wisdom only.